men, death came to Gino Hernandez. Wrestling fans were shocked at the sudden end to one of the brightest careers in the game. His friends were saddened by an irreplaceable loss of a vibrant young spirit. To his mother and sister, it was a tragedy of indescribable magnitude. Gino started his wrestling career here in Houston within days of his 18th birthday. But that was not the beginning. It was the continuation of a dream that had obsessed him since the death of his stepfather following a match in Tokyo, Japan. It took a lot of hard work to increase his weight and strength to the level he wanted them. But when experience and sweat combined, he received the worldwide recognition he had well earned. But more than that, Gino had a way of attracting friends. He had a way of using his God-given talents to reach out and touch those who had not been blessed. He will be remembered as a fine young athlete who had won many honors. But perhaps the greatest accolade will come from those who recall that he helped them just by a word or a touch, or perhaps just by being Gino. It's difficult, very difficult, to say goodbye to a friend in public. For each of us, grief is a private emotion. What words cannot say, we have put into an expression in video, prepared here in the studios of Channel 39 by Ed Worthington. And we play it on this program because Gino appeared here so many hundreds of times. It's our expression of our feelings toward him and our love to his family.
And now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain. My friend, I'll say it clear, I stayed my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived, life is full, I traveled each and every highway and more. It's more than this, I did it my regrets. I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do and saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway. Oh, and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew. My share of losing, and now as tears subside, I find it all so amusing to think I did all that, and may I say, not in a shy way. I did it my way. Oh, what is a man? What has he got? Not himself, and he has not to say the word he truly feels. He has the word.
I was the youngest guy to ever wrestle in Madison Square Garden at the age of 19. I've been the American heavyweight champion. I've been the world junior heavyweight champion, one half of the world tag team champion. I've been the youngest man to ever wrestle in the Arena Mexico in Mexico City. I've been the youngest man to hold the American heavyweight title. I won that in Cobo Arena in Detroit, Michigan. I know for a fact that I was one of the youngest wrestlers ever to go toward Japan. And I know for a fact also that I'm the youngest man to ever wrestle the world heavyweight champion. And I think I've accomplished more at the age of 23 in wrestling than most wrestlers accomplish in a lifetime.